There has never been a time when biodiversity and ecosystem services have been more relevant to governments, businesses, and communities in shaping our future. Biodiversity underpins almost every aspect of human development. It is key to the Sustainable Development Goals, the Paris Agreement on Climate Change, and the Aichi Biodiversity Targets. From food, clean water, health, and jobs, to issues of peace and security, it has become imperative for decision makers to know more about how their choices affect and are affected by the environment. Yet natural resources are being depleted and degraded faster now than at any other point in human history. This is why the work of the Intergovernmental Science Policy Platform on Biodiversity and Ecosystem Services is so important. IPBES brings together expertise from across disciplines, borders, and communities, providing the knowledge we need to develop policies that benefit people and our planet. IPBES made its first real public impression with the launch of the first two IPBES assessments at the fourth session of the plenary in Malaysia, featuring not only news reports around the world, but even in pop culture. The assessment launches were followed by expert articles, reviewing and building on IPBES's findings. Most importantly, 2016 saw IPBES making its first policy impact, with a formal endorsement by the 13th meeting of the Conference of the Parties to the Convention on Biological Diversity of key messages from the IPBES pollination assessment. COP13 also encouraged actions on the findings of the IPBES scenarios and models assessment. The most visible policy impact has been the ever-expanding list of national strategies based on the outcomes of the IPBES pollination assessment, leading to the creation by a growing number of governments of a coalition of the willing to protect pollinators and to promote pollination around the world. In addition to IPBES's impact at major global development events, 2016 was a year of many other IPBES milestones. Authors meetings for the upcoming regional assessments, the land degradation assessment, and the global assessment. Extensive work by the task forces on knowledge and data, indigenous and local knowledge, and capacity building. Dialogue workshops in Asia Pacific and the Americas. The first phase two workshop on scenarios. Workshops to support integration of the values and valuation of biodiversity in IPBES's assessments, and an unprecedented level of IPBES outreach through social media. So what's next for IPBES? The Land Degradation and Restoration Assessment, and the four regional assessments on biodiversity and ecosystem services are making great progress. They will feed into the IPBES Global Assessment, offering the first comprehensive snapshot of the state of knowledge on global biodiversity since the 2005 Millennium Ecosystem Assessment. This will also help measure progress against the Aichi targets to be met by 2020. New IPBES assessments could also be launched this year, with discussions beginning about a potential future IPBES work program for 2019 and beyond as well. A new approach to the inclusion of indigenous and local knowledge in all IPBES assessments and a review of IPBES's effectiveness will also feature in the year ahead, with a renewed focus on ever closer collaboration with our stakeholders and partners. We need your help. From cabinet rooms to boardrooms, from households to individuals, we can make better decisions about biodiversity and ecosystem services. As IPBES takes the next steps in its mission to strengthen knowledge foundations for better policy through science, there is a role for every person at every level. Through renewed political commitment, greater levels of resources, the nomination of experts, the contribution of expertise, and simple word-of-mouth advocacy, we can help deepen IPBES's impact. the future we want can only be built on solid, sustainable foundations. With your support, IPBES will continue to bridge the divide between science and policy for people and nature.